各位同学，大家好，我是蒋小珍，欢迎收看我们今天英文翻译第一次的播出。我们今天要谈中英翻译的概论，也就是说翻译的哪些基本的方法跟技巧。首先来介绍和我一块主持节目的魏老师。Hi, Charles。
大家好，我是魏晨的。Welcome to the show。
Okay, welcome to the show。老师跟我一起主持英文翻译节目，从上学期到现在哈。Hi Charles, what happened to your arm?
Not in traffic like everybody seems to think. No, I was at the house. I took a shower. The floor was slippery and this. So we
okay,
figured we shouldn't hide. If we hide it, it'll just draw more attention to it. So let's get it out of the way now.
老师在浴室里面摔了一跤哈，一定很痛。Okay, we hope you recover soon.
Well, that makes two of us.
Okay, 好，那我们先看今天的翻译原理 principles of translation。上学期我们谈了许多翻译的理论，如果你还记得的话，譬如有翻译的标准原则，中英语言架构的对比，英汉文化对比与翻译等等。其实中文和英文是两种不同的语言，它们差异显现在它的句序、句子的顺序，还有字序、字的顺序，它们不尽相同。那中英文它们的句法也各有特色，再加上呢中英文化的差异，所以使这两种语言他们在相互译的时候哈，需要运用一些策略方法和技巧，那么才能达到呢以前我们说过的信达雅，这是翻译的基本原则和标准。这学期呢我们要做一些实际的应用哈。那么说到翻译的方法，最基本也是我们大家最常用的就是一个叫直译法，就照字面逐字翻译，英文是 word by word。 在中英互译的时候，有时候可以使用这种方法，直译法，但是呢这种很机械式的对应的译法并不是适用于所有的中英翻译句型，所以有些直译法处理后的译文不但不够通顺，而且更没有文采可言。所以中英翻译的基本方法和技巧，除了直译法以外，还有许多其他的方法，都可以把原文的原意以比较灵巧活泼的一种方式哈，把它转译在我们的译文当中。Hi Charles, what do you think?
Basically, translation is more than word by word rendition. You should use other strategies as well.
所以我们老说要用一些strategies 一些技巧策略。在周兆祥先生他那一本《翻译与人生》这本书里面提到，袁慧秉先生他所提的翻译的方法有四个字，叫做删存补调。那么中英翻译的基本策略就是把直译以后的文字，我们要删除它的赘字赘义，使原文含义呢精简清晰地呈现在译文中。此外还要删去译文繁琐的部分，存留它精义的部分。所以翻译的基本入门就是删还有存这两个方法。有些原文的直译我们运用了刚刚讲的删去存的法之外呢，还是没有办法达译，那这时候我们考虑补和调的方法。补就是补足哈，增加的意思，在译文中我们要符合它语文的习惯，可以补它，补一些字就是补充来或补足。还有呢，为了使译文的逻辑和它思考的方式就可以把你直译的译文有些部分移前或者移后或者放中间，这叫调，调转的意思。所以这四个策略就是我们所说的中英翻译的基本方法。好，那这个基本的精神呢哈，我们就是说要文字是一个灵活的一个变化，你不要拘泥在很僵硬的形式而破坏了语义的这种自然的转换。那刚刚讲这四个字删存补调，也就是说把不合的把它删缩， 合宜的存留，暧昧不清的我们增补说明，次序错乱的我们倒转掉头过来。 Charles, would you please summarize the main ideas, the methods of translation?
First, you can delete or cut out unnecessary words. Second, we should retain the core of original meaning. Make sure you do that. Mm-hmm. Third, we can add words or phrases to clarify the meaning. And fourth, we can rearrange the order of words or phrases to make translation logical and meaningful.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. 老师做了很好的一个 summary, 哈。那我觉得除此之外另一位教授叫许渊冲教授，他更进一步用蛮有趣的数学的公式哈来表达翻译的技巧。我介绍给同学看，他有减词，二减一等于二，还有换词，二加二等于三加一，合词，二加二等于四，移词，一加二等于二加一哈，就从他的文学翻译台里面挑出来的。这几条数学公式包括了好几种中英翻译的基本技巧，那就是如我们这学期会介绍，叫做减词法，还有换词法，还有合词法，还有移词法等等。那刚刚这个数学等式两边应该是相等哈，譬如二减一等于二，这是我们用来做说明的哈，那就是减那个词不减义。那么再一个二加二等于三加一，就是换了词但是不换意思。二加二等于四，就是合词合起来但是不增加意思哈，合词不增义。还有一加一二等于二加一，就是移词不移义哈，词移动可是意思没有变。我们举例说明，例如
Where there is a will, there is a way。
我们照直译来说，那里有一个意志，有一条路，好像太繁琐。我们简词简简看，有意志有路，听起来怪怪的。不如我们再换换词，有志者事竟成，这是我们常说的这个成语，在换的翻译的过程当中，有这几个思考在里面。所以原文的意思在减，在换，在合，在移，处理之后的译文中间，我们仍然不会失去原来的本意。所以我们说灵巧变化要不离其旨，这是翻译的方法和技巧的基本原则。许教授更提出翻译的方法应该要深化、浅化还有等化。什么叫深化？深化就包括一个具体化还有加词法。那么浅化呢，它包括比较抽象化还有减词法。等化就是说包括了词性的转换，正说反说，还有主动被动的互换。那这是几个重要的方法。我们先休息一下。本学期所讨论的中英翻译的基本方法和技巧，我们来介绍如下。譬如说有单句同步转换，单句局部非同步转换，词类转换，增词翻译，省略法，词语义引申翻译，正反转换法，重复法，成语套用替代翻译，解释补足法，音译法，主动被动句法，分句合句拆译法，从句翻译法。这些中英翻译的基本方法和技巧，分别要在我们以后的每一次讲次当中逐一为大家举例说明。现在我们介绍一下中外的名言 famous quotations。 这学期我们也介绍了一些中外名言，那就是从名言当中学习一些翻译，那也可以激励自己。我们看一看这些名言。
Brevity is the soul of wit。
这莎士比亚的名言说简洁是机智的灵魂。
Frailty, thy name is woman。
脆弱啊， 你的名字就是女人，这是莎士比亚的名言哈。
Men at some time are masters of their fates.
人们有时可以主宰自己的命运，莎士比亚说的。
All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players.
全世界是一个舞台，所有的男男女女都不过是一些演员，这莎士比亚名言哈。好，我们先看看中外名言到这里了。下面要看一下我们今天绘画的一些单字 ，vocabulary and expressions。
Shut，
闭上。
Ruckus，
喧闹、骚动。
Feed。
喂食。
Scratch，
用指甲抓。
Just in case，
以防万一。
Housebroken，
指猫狗等受过训练而能保持家里清洁的。
Young blood，
年轻小子。
Caution，
警告。
Least，
最少程度最轻的。
In return，
作为回报，作为回应。
Get away from it all，
逃离现实。
Cram course，
补习课程。
Blazing，
炙热。
Mile，
英里。
Hunting，
狩猎的。
Breed，
品种。
Row，
划船。
Canoe，
独木舟。
Look forward to，
盼望、期待。好，这是我们今天的单字哈。那我们下面看一看同学们为我们把这个绘画来用英文先演出。
Already gotten breakfast started. How long have you been up?
A little while. I woke up just as it was growing light and tried shutting my eyes, but no go.
Maybe the ruckus Queenie and Double Oat raised with their barking had something to do with it?
Hard to say. I fed them once they came scratching on the door. Yeah, make sure not to let them in, just in case they are not housebroken.
That was one thing the young bloods cautioned us to remember. To feed them, I mean. The least we can do in return for spending a few days here and get away from it all while they teach cram courses back in town.
Guess that's time for a jog along the shore before it gets blazing hot. Less than a mile all the way around. Can we keep this warm until I get back?
Most likely.Are Queenie and Double Oats going with you?
If they want to.
They're hunting breeds, you know, able to run with people.
I'll see you in about half an hour. Then we all row the canoe all the way across.
I'm looking forward to it.
Good. We can see that this is two young people. They're like a vacation在一个非常优雅的地方吃早餐这样哈，那他们谈到这个 pet 的 pets 狗哈，你知道如果狗在家里面有训练过不弄脏怎么说吗？刚刚讲的叫 housebroken， 这个字蛮有趣的哈。好，我们在刚刚这段是英文，我们先看一下中文部分，你注意看看你看懂了没有？
You already gotten breakfast started. How long have you been up?
A little while. I woke up just as it was growing light and tried shutting my eyes, but no go.
Maybe the ruckus Queenie and Double Oat raised with their barking had something to do with it?
Hard to say. I fed them once they came scratching on the door. Yeah, make sure not to let them in, just in case they are not housebroken.
That was one thing the young bloods cautioned us to remember. To feed them, I mean. The least we can do in return for spending a few days here and get away from it all while they teach cramp courses back in town.
Guess that's time for a jog along the shore before it gets blazing hot. Less than a mile all the way around. Can we keep this warm until I get back?
Most likely. Are Queenie and Double Oaks going with you?
If they want to.
They're hunting breeds, you know, able to run with people.
I'll see you in about half an hour. Then we all row the canoe all the way across.
I'm looking forward to it.
Good. 我们感谢彰化师大英语系同学为我们演出的哈。我想问问那个 Charles 老师 ，What are the names of the dogs？
Queenie and Double Odd are their names.
Queenie 就是 Queen 是女王 ，Queenie 小女王 ，Double Odd 就是双灵哈，很有趣的名字。好，来我们看今天的 questions。
Question one: Where does this conversation take place？A, factory, B, lake house, C, restaurant, D, school.
B, lake house.
Question two, what relation is the woman to the man? A, wife, B, sister, C, cousin, D, we can't tell from the story.
D, we can't tell from the story.
No, we can't. Question three, which are Queenie and Double Ought to the Youngbloods? A, children,B, students, C, pets, D, tenants.
C, pets.
Question four, what time of year does this dialogue probably occur? A, summer, B, autumn, C, winter, D, spring.
A, summer. 夏天的哈。好，这是我们今天的问题部分。那下面我们来看看 Let's practice 句型翻译练习。先看第一个例句。
Maybe the ruckus Queenie and Double Ought raised with their barking had something to do with it.
或许跟小女王和双灵吼叫造成的喧闹有关。我们来做 be or have something to do with something 与什么有关？新政策可能与经济有关系。
The new policy might have something to do with economics.The new policy has something to do with economics.
哪一个错了？
Well, because you need to translate 可能 you have to say might or may.、See, and the second one doesn't have it, so the first one better.
对，老师说得很好，因为我们中文是可能哈，那你要 might or may， 你这个第二句没有把这个可能翻出来，所以第一个比较好。那我们有没有另外的翻法？
These novel measures could relate to the economy.
好，新 novel 也可以讲新的哈 ，measures 就是这个策略啦、政策啦、方法，那 relate 有关的意思。好，那我们先到这里休息一下。好，刚刚我们看那句话是have something to do 或 be something to do with something。Charles, what's the difference?
Well, not much. Just that have something to do with it is much more common. Sometimes we say, I think it's something to do with, but most of the time that means has. But occasionally we will say is or something.
分这两句话其实都可以，但是 have something to do 好像比较普遍一点哈。好，来我们看看下一句。这道菜闻起来怪怪的，也许跟烹调方式有关系。我们提示一下，英文里面一道菜叫 course， 哈，好，来试试看。
This course smells strange. It might have something to do with the way it's cooked. This course smells strange. It might have something to do with the way it cooked.
哪一个错了？
Well, they're both grammatically right. It's just that it's in the, I mean, cooked in the first one is a VT and、and.Passive voice, and then the second one is more like a VI. So in this sense, we would use a VT.
好， 那其实哈，我们看看菜是我们中文说应该是被烹调的哈 ，it is cooked。那你第二句用 it cooked 好像这个不好哈，所以基本上第一个对。我们请老师另外说说看别的方法。
This dish has a peculiar smell, maybe because of how it was prepared.
这 peculiar 好像很 strange， peculiar 就是意思都是很奇怪的意思哈。好，我们看看下一句。
I fed them once they came scratching on the door, yet made sure not to let them in, just in case they're not housebroken.
当他们用爪子抓门的时候，我喂了他们，并确保他们都待在外面，以防他们不是什么训练有素的宠物。好，我们来做做看。Just in case， 以防万一。我泡了些茶，以防我们待会儿口渴。
I've made some tea just in case we get thirst later. I've made some tea just in case we get thirsty later.
哪边错了？
Grammatically right, both of them, but we don't say get thirst. We say get thirsty.
Get 后面用形容词哈 ，get thirsty 才对哈。好，有没有另外的翻译方法
？Should we get thirsty after a while? I've got some tea ready.
这句话很有意思哈。Should we get thirsty?意思说 ，if we should get thirsty， 万一我们口渴，这是一个倒装句哈，一个这个假设 if 的开句子，所以这里可以学习一下。好，我们看下面。我不觉得会下雨，但我会带件雨衣以防万一。
I don't think it's going to rain, but I'll bring a raincoat just in case. I don't feel it's going to rain.But I'll bring a raincoat just in case.
哪边错了？
They say feel it's going to rain. We don't do that. But some people even insist they can smell rain, or some people say they can smell a hurricane or typhoon, as you call it. But we don't say it that way.
好，中文是我不觉得，所以你可能想，I don't feel. 其实这不是英文。老师，有的人说他 I can smell 会。嗅觉到
some
有的人会这样说哈，但是我们基本上是 I don't think 这样就好了哈。好，那这句话我们再看一下这个另外的方法。
Though I doubt it will rain, I'll take along a raincoat to play it safe.
虽然哈 though 哈，我怀疑它会下雨，但是我还是带个雨衣哈 ，to play it safe 就以测安全哈，以防万一，这个也很好，可以学起来。好，我们看下面。
That was one thing the young bloods cautioned us to remember, to feed them. I mean, the least we can do in return for spending a few days here and getting away from it all while they teach cram courses back in town.
这是杨伯乐一家提醒我们要记得的事情，喂他们。我是说，这至少是我们可以回报的。当他们在城里教补习班课程时，我们待在这几天，逃离现实。这个 young bloods, what does that mean?
Well, you saw that in the vocabulary, but it can also be a surname.
我们刚刚单字把它讲成是年轻的一代啊，那也可以，那是小写，但大写表示这是一家人。我们把它翻译杨伯乐啊 ，young bloods 很有趣。那我们今天这句话，我们来学 in return， 作为回报，作为回应。我们能做什么来回报你的慷慨呢？慷慨怎么说
？Generosity。
好，我们来做做看。
What can we do in return to your generosity? What can we do in return for your generosity?
哪一个对？
The first one sounds like Chinglish.
这个 for 比较好 ，to 不对哈。第一个像中国的这个英文。好，来我们看看翻译。
How can we repay your magnanimity?
好 ，magnanimity 也是慷慨的意思。好，这次学起来。下面我们看。政府协助流亡者以换取他们提供情资的承诺。我们提示一下，流亡者怎么说？
Refugee。
那么情资呢
？Intelligence。
好，做做看。
Government helped the refugees in return for their promise to provide intelligence. Government helped the refugees in return for their promise provide intelligence.
好，看哪一个错了？
To make it grammatical, you have to have a to for because it's an infinitive form.
对这个哈，应该说 promise to provide 少个 to 不行。我们另外做做看。
The government lent a hand to refugees who pledged to cooperate by supplying information.
很好 ，lend a hand 是帮忙的意思，哈，好协助的意思。我们看下面的例句。
They're hunting breeds, you know, able to run with people.
他们属于狩猎的品种，你知道的，能和人一起奔跑。我们来学一个 be able to， 有能力做什么事情。不好意思，我昨天无法与你见面。
I'm sorry that I wasn't able to meet you yesterday. I'm sorry I am not able to meet you yesterday.
哎，哪边错了？
Believe it or not, the first one's more grammatical because I know it mixes tenses, which you usually aren't supposed to do. But the second one is definitely Chinglish.
好，你看，因为是 yesterday 昨天啊，那不可能是 I am， 要 I was 比较好哈，这正确的。来，我们另外翻翻看。
Regretfully, I couldn't meet you yesterday.
你说 I'm sorry， 就是 regretfully 啊，不好意思哈。好，我们看下一句。Tommy 几乎无法。跑或跳。
Tommy barely be able to run or jump. Tommy is barely able to run or jump.
哪边错了？
First one's not only Chinglish. It's also archaic English, maybe. They may have talked like that 1,000 years ago, but not anymore.
几千年前呢、啊？那我们看 B 要用 is 才对哈。好，另外翻翻看。
Tommy can hardly run or jump.
Hardly, barely 都是几乎不的意思哈。好来，我们看下面。
I'm looking forward to it.
我会很期待。我们来学一个 look forward to 后面加动词 ing 或者名词哈，盼望、期待，来试试看。他努力工作并盼望能升迁，升迁叫 promote， 来试试看。
She had worked hard and was looking forward to being promoted. She had worked hard and was looking forward to be promoted.
好，看哪个错了。
The second one, if you said expected, expecting, you could do it. But when we say looking forward to, you have to use the ing form.
好，我们可以用。
So it makes it a prepositional phrase.
Yeah, expect. 或是这个刚刚讲过 ，looking forward to 后面要加动名词，所以 being 才对。来，我们另外翻翻看。
She had shown diligence and expected to move up in the ranks.
Ranks 阶级往上爬哈。好，我们看下一句。我相当期待能与你对话。
I'm really looking forward to talk with you. I'm really looking forward to talking with you.
哪边错了？
First one's grammatically right, but it's Chinglish because I mean talk can be a noun or a verb, but in this sense we would use the ing form.
对 ，ing 才正确，用动名词哈，不要忘记。好了，我们看另外的说法。
I truly wish to compare notes with you.
好，我们看 compare notes with you 就跟你对话的意思。跟你的一个绘画对话的这个机制哈，好，来我们看啊，今天我们的这个课程谈到这里，那么我们刚刚讲到这个狗的名字蛮有趣的哈，那个叫 Queenie， 小女王，
yes.
还有个 Double R， 你看两个零 Double R， 有趣哈，你可以叫任何你的狗的名字，我们家叫 Yellow 啊什么的哈，这个 Lucky 都可以。好，那我们今天先上到这里，那下次我们要讲单句同步转换。下回见，拜拜。